Well, that didn't work. I wrote a totally professional report listing all the reasons why my family should go on a cruise this year, and they didn't even take the time to read it. Word processing software is great for producing informative text documents. But when it comes to producing eye-catching, engaging presentations, text on a page just isn't good enough. You need plenty of graphics and excitement to catch an audience's attention. If you find yourself tasked with sharing a book report with your class, persuading your family to take a trip to the aquarium, or proposing a get-rich-quick scheme to your friends, you'll need to make effective use of presentation software. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to use presentation software to produce creative and engaging presentations for a variety of purposes. Let's get into it. My friend B will be demonstrating the different features of presentation software using Google Slides, which is one particular presentation app that you can access for free by logging into a Google account. If you have different presentation software you'd like to use, that's fine too. You can still follow along. Just be aware that presentation software varies greatly between programs, so similar features might look different or be found in different places on the interface, or some features might be missing entirely. Take it away, B!
Hey, it's B again, here to show you how to create super engaging presentations using presentation software. When you open a blank presentation, your view will look something like this. The method for naming your presentation is the same as for word processing software, so go ahead and name your presentation now. Right here is where you'll design your slides that will be presented to your audience. Using the tools that you'll find on the toolbar and in the menu bar. Right here, you will see all of your slides as you create them, so you can quickly navigate between them as you work. Let's take a look at the tools you can use to create your presentation slides. Most presentation software offers pre-made themes or designs you can use to give your presentation a cool look. Check out the themes or designs that are available on the presentation software you are using. Some of them are simple, like this nice gray theme, while others are elaborate and colorful, like this one. Find a theme that fits the subject of your presentation. If none of the pre-made themes fit your presentation, don't worry. You can customize your own using the background setting. This lets you choose a custom color or even a cool image you found to use as the background of your slides. Try changing the background of your slides now. I'm going to stick with a blank white theme for now, so we won't have to worry about any clashing colors. You can also choose different layouts for each of your slides, depending on how you plan to use that slide. For instance, you can use a title slide layout for your first slide, complete with text boxes for a title and a subtitle. Then you can add a new slide using this button and change its layout to one that includes a title line, plenty of space for an image, and a column of text explaining the image. Don't worry though, you aren't stuck with just these predefined layouts. You have plenty of tools at your disposal to make your presentation slides however you want. For the rest of this lesson, I'll be using blank layouts so I can create my slides exactly how I want them. You can create a text box by clicking this button and then dragging across where you want the text box to appear. As you type inside the text box, you'll notice that the toolbar looks familiar. It has most of the same text formatting tools that we learned about in the lessons on word processing software. Text boxes are basically mini text documents. So you can format the text in the same ways. See? You can also change the text box's size and shape by dragging the points around the edges. And move it around by dragging its borders in order to place your text exactly where you want it. In fact, it's that easy to manipulate pretty much any object you insert on your slides. If you experimented with inserting images in word processing software, you learned just how difficult it was to get the image where you wanted it without it interfering with the text. With presentation software, you can insert images that won't interfere with text at all, no matter where you place them or how big they are. The same goes with inserting different types of shapes and lines. Presentation software is specifically designed so that you can put all these things together without any issues. The toolbar even changes based on what object is selected, so you can change things like the colors of the objects. Try it for yourself and see what you can create. A slide with text and images looks nice, but what's more interesting? This lack of a transition from one slide to the next? Or this cube transition? The transition tool changes how your presentation moves from one slide to the next. There are a lot of different transitions available, so check them out. You'll notice that the panel where you pick a transition also includes a section for object animations. With animations, you can take a boring slide like this and make it more interesting by having different objects enter the screen, exit the screen, and move around during your presentation. To add animations, select the object you want to animate. Click the Animate tool on the toolbar, then change the style of animation and timing. If you want to test your animations to make sure they look how you want them to, click the Play button and it will play the slide as if you were presenting it. Some presentation software even has tools to insert formatted diagrams, so you don't have to try to make them yourself out of shapes and lines. There are a lot of different types of diagrams you can make, so play around with them. When you're ready to present your work to others, find the button labeled Slideshow or Present. This will make your presentation full screen. And you can move through the slides and animations using a mouse, spacebar, or the arrow keys on a keyboard. If you wrote any notes or reminders to yourself in the presenter notes, you can use Presenter View instead. Your slides will appear on the projector screen for your audience, while only you can see your presenter notes on your personal screen. It takes hard work to produce a professional-level presentation, so here are some tips. First, don't overload your slides with text or images. Too much on a slide can overwhelm your audience. Instead of writing every little detail or having a bunch of images on your slides, provide just enough information that the slides make sense, and leave the details in your head or in the presenter notes. Also, don't have all your information appear at once. If you have 4 bullet points, you don't want your audience focusing on point number 4 while you're still talking about why point number 2 is important. To keep people focused on what you're talking about, Use animations to hide things until you are ready to talk about them. With these tools and tips at your disposal, you're ready to create presentations to wow any audience. Until next time!
Thanks, V! Now that you know the tools at your disposal with presentation software, the only thing left to do is experiment with them! The PDF for this lesson includes suggestions for practice projects that will help you hone your skills with using presentation software. You can choose some of these mini projects to do, come up with your own projects you'd like to do, or play around on presentation software without a specific goal in mind to see what you can create. Once you think you're a pro at using presentation software, you'll be ready to move on to the next lesson, which is all about spreadsheet software. This is software that allows you to organize information like home library catalogs, perform automatic calculations for things like a family budget, or even turn data into graphs that you can use to enhance your presentation even more. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have. So keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time. Hey, hey.